It's Red Nose Day, and as you can imagine, there are fundraising efforts taking place all over the country, and the SGN dispatch office at Walton Park is no exception. We've taken liberties of filming our very own fundraising efforts for Comic Relief, and I've talked to individuals within dispatch who actively participate in charity work as part of their personal and social responsibility. So let's find out who is doing what.
Hi, my name's Liz, I work in customer service at SGN. I support Comic Relief and we've been making little bits and bobs to sell. We've got a few left, we've sold quite a lot already and it's only 1 o'clock and we've still got two lots of shift people to come in. So we've got earrings, brooches, phone charms and things like that. Wearing my pyjamas, I've got my hair rollers in and I'm looking rather silly, but it's all for a good cause. Peace.
I'm Jim Bonner and I do data capture for the data capture team for SGN.
Can you tell us why you're dressed in this lovely outfit?
I'm here to raise money for Red Nose Day, currently raised £79.
Hello, my name is Claire, I'm a dispatcher at SGN and I support Comic Relief, which is why today I've come to work in my pyjamas.
Hi. I'm Sarah and I work on customer service and I support Comic Relief and so do my slippers and I am wearing pyjamas because I woke up late.
Now there's more to come on some of the fundraising initiatives. In the meantime, however, let's find out more about what actually goes on within dispatch itself, and for that, let's meet some of the managers.
Hello, I'm Paul Morris, I'm a dispatch team manager. I've been doing the job for approximately 4 years. Dispatch has been a busy environment in that time and it's still busy today. We cover a lot of work, including emergency, metering and customer service. 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Main focus behind dispatch is safety though. It's a key value for the company. We need to make sure that we're all working hard to get to that. Make sure that we are attending gas escapes within the hour if necessary. Also got to make sure we are keeping the customer first, and if there are any problems we need to make sure they're in the know and informed about what's going on at their property. Obviously the company has its five main values. One that we've been focusing on quite recently here in dispatch is Our World. Obviously we do care about our local community, we do get involved in the Community Action Programme to help out. We've done various activities down here, some with local authorities to help keep the areas tidy, natural interest, and others helping the community itself.
When we consider our other values, it's great to see through the Our World value that we're now bringing forward this CAP initiative, and to really address that we've obviously put Nicola Wickham not full time but actually leading on that as a department, so we've got some focus and we're putting something back into the community. So it's been great to see a number of initiatives already being progressed through that.
As a whole, I think the company's doing really well. The past 5 years we've had many achievements. One coming up very shortly is our switch away from National Grid for our gas control section. So that'll end a lot of our all involvement now and reliability on National Grid, and we'll be our own company. I think we have some big challenges in the commercial world. Whilst we stay safe, keep our customers safe, we must become a commercial entity.
Now, SGN has five core values, but one in particular is central to our Community Action Programme, a scheme that gives members of staff the opportunity to volunteer within their local community during working hours. Now, let's meet two dispatch members who decided to get involved and give back.
Hi, my name is Dave Orison. Myself and my team took part in a CAP initiative a couple of weeks ago. And we were asked to go back and help Solent Rescue out at Leap Country Park in Southampton. Basically, when we got there, we were asked to do a variety of tasks, including walking around, making sure everyone was safe. We'd done it during Cows Week, so as you can imagine, it was quite busy. We walked around, obviously, with first aid kit. We also helped out in the lookout tower, and we got the chance to ride in the rescue boat, which was really, really cool.
My name's Patrick. I work within the customer service department within SGN Dispatch. I recently took part in the CAP scheme. My particular role was doing the leaflet drops for the Good Neighbourhood scheme. I thoroughly believe this was quite a good scheme because it's helping people help each other. Now the main aim of the scheme was basically to drop the leaflets into as many doors as we could within the Havant and Bedhampton area.
Interesting stuff. If you wish to take part in the CAP initiative, please contact Nicola Wickham by the email you can see at the bottom of the screen. But coming up next are four individuals who've done some amazing things for charity. And here they are telling you in their own words what they've done, why, and how.
Meet Dave Dawkins, a dispatcher who has helped raise thousands of pounds for charity through his passion for cycling. Dave has helped organise many fundraising events over the years, and so we decided to catch up with them to find out what's in store for this year.
This year's charity event is for Macmillan Cancer Support, whereas I'm trying to get every depot I'm involved, every depot and every office to do a 25-mile cycle ride from a local route. Each depot and office can plan their own route. It will take place on the same day, which will be June the 19th. And then once everyone's done the ride, we can get all the money together and pass it down to me. We'll put it in a big pot. And then after that, we're going to have a no bringing your car to work day, so cycle and walking day. And fine people for bringing their cars in, and those who don't bring bikes in and stuff like that. So a bit more money can go into the pot. And at the end of that, at the year, me and myself and Steve Powell are going to be cycling up to Dundee from Walton Park, which is a couple of 600 miles, doing about 100 miles a day, again, just to boost the money up for the charity. And at the end of all that, at the summer cycling, we'll hand the money over to Macmillan. Hopefully raise a good fair amount, £20,000-£30,000 towards it.
My name's Annette Robertson. I'm a quality and performance advisor for the customer service team within Dispatch. A couple of years ago, I ran the London Marathon for Save the Rhino. I raised just over £1,300. Twice a year, I also do a collection for Friends of the Homeless in Fareham and Gosport. We organise everything from sleeping bags and old duvets right the way through to toiletries and all your sort of food essentials. Last year, I also did a photo shoot for a locally organised calendar for breast cancer awareness. I will also be doing the same photo shoot in a couple of weeks' time. We wear nothing but a pink prop for that. We managed to raise just over £400 last year, and we're hoping to get just over £1,000 this year.
Hello, my name's Greg Rowell. I work in data at Walton Park in Portsmouth for SGN. Very busy section, and I have taken an initiative on raising money for charity, with a charity called Mind, which is a charity that basically represents mental health and the improvement of mental health. The initiatives that I've taken at SGN have been on a few fronts. One was basically to have a dress down day where I raised money from everybody and they all turned up in scruffy jeans, etc. I went through the whole building in Bolton Park, including SGN staff and SSE staff and some IBM contractors, and I was able to raise over £250. And I'm hoping to get up to the £500 so that I can get the matching from SGN, so that would make a total of £1,000. Apart from the dress down day, I've also organised a photographic competition to raise more money for Mind, which is closing date's just gone, so we're judging the photographs and there will be prizes. The rest of the money will go to Mind.
And this is Nicola Wickham. She has worked for SGN for 5 years and currently works within our technical team in Dispatch. Nicola sponsors a child in Africa through a UK-based charity. She makes a monthly contribution towards the welfare of a child whose parents cannot afford the things we take for granted.
I sponsor Abdu through the charity Plan UK, which I pay monthly. It's currently £20 a month, and the money goes directly to him and his family. It allows him to go to school, it allows him to have clothing and all his medication he needs. It also gives him shoes, which is very important.
Now, in addition to all the individual efforts, Dispatch also donated £1,500 to the Rainbow Centre, a local charity that provides specialist care to children with disabilities. I was invited to attend one of those sessions because they wanted you to see how your money is making a difference.
Hello, my name is Julie Woodward and I work on the fundraising team here at the centre and I do community and events fundraising.
My name is Beth Rogers. I work with Julie in the community and events fundraising side of the Rainbow Centre.
The centre helps children with cerebral palsy. Currently we have about 65 families who come to us, some on a daily basis, some once a week, some twice a week, to receive a system of learning called conductive education. It costs quite a lot to run the centre. It's just over £45,000 every month. Now, the Rainbow Centre doesn't get any statutory funding, so the money that we raise has to come from our own fundraising efforts for events that we put on, but also we rely tremendously on the local community to raise money for us.
And local businesses as well. And I mean, SGN have raised an amazing amount of money for us. Lisa popped down with some of her colleagues the other day and gave us a cheque for £1,500, which makes a huge difference here. I mean, £45,000 a month, so £1,500 runs this place for a day, and that means, obviously, depending on which day, but there's so many sessions here. That's helping adults, that's helping our small children, our older children. There's a huge amount of running costs for a building of this size, the staffing, the heating, and those are the less glamorous things that people want to pay for, but those are the things we really need the money for, so your guys' efforts will make a huge difference here.
The Rainbow Centre is truly a remarkable place, and the services they provide has transformed many lives. Rest assured, money raised will be put to good use.
This video was made to celebrate Comic Relief and to highlight one of SGN's core values. We're constantly looking at ways to best influence the world around us, and raising money for charity is just one part of that vision. Now let's end by rejoining our fundraising efforts in Dispatch. Thank you for watching.
Hi, my name's Angelo. I work in the admin team, or technical team, depending which way you look at it. And I support Comic Relief. Yay!
Hi, my name's Tom, I work for SGN as a dispatcher and I support Comic Relief.
Hi, my name's Porter, I work for SGN Dispatch and we support Comic Relief.
My name is Marie-Ève, I work on a dispatch area for repair team, and I'm in red today because I support Red Nose Day.
Hi, my name's John. I'm a dispatcher for SGN. I work on a semi patch. I support Comic Relief.
Hi, my name is Bumper and I work for SGN Dispatch, and this is for Comic Relief.
W5, don't be filming me. You need permission
for
performing rights, okay?
You're not performing.
I am.
Not.
This is a performance, life sustainable. Yeah.
Hi, I'm Lisa.
Oh no, I'm sorry. I thought you said count to five.
Me.
You did.
Criteria?
It's a half day and you have to help someone in your local community either doing...
That's that bit again.